The future of construction is more exciting than ever thanks to huge technological developments in material innovation. Researchers are constantly developing new materials that are stronger and lighter than ever before, paving the way to a more energy-efficient and eco-friendly future in everything from transportation to medical technology. Aggregated diamond nanorods is at number 5. You still have to respect diamonds. They're not as fancy as some of the new materials out there, but they are still extremely strong and lightweight. Other things to keep in mind about diamonds: they are made of the widely available element of carbon, they offer nearly complete thermal conductivity, and have among the highest melting and boiling points of all materials. Don't forget that graphene. Nanodiamond was convincingly demonstrated to be produced by compression of graphite in 2003, and in the same work found to be much harder than bulk diamond. Later it was also produced by compression of fullerene and confirmed to be the hardest and least compressible known material, with an isothermal bulk modulus of 491 gigapascals, GPa, while a conventional diamond has a modulus of 442 to 446 gigapascals. These results were inferred from X-ray diffraction data, which also indicated that ADNRs are 0.3% denser than regular diamond. Metamaterials is at number 4. The invisibility cloak has long been something fantasized about by sci-fi fans and invested in by certain military contractors. The concept is based on the idea that materials with negative electromagnetic properties could reflect light back at its source. A rough way of explaining how this type of material could render something invisible to the naked eye. One key factor: they can also be very light. A metamaterial is a material engineered to have a property that is not found in nature. They are made from assemblies of multiple elements fashioned from composite materials such as metals or plastics. The materials are usually arranged in repeating patterns, at scales that are smaller than the wavelengths of the phenomena they influence. Metamaterials derive their properties not from the properties of the base materials, but from their newly designed structures. Their precise shape, geometry, size, orientation and arrangement gives them their smart properties capable of manipulating electromagnetic waves, by blocking, absorbing, enhancing, or bending waves, to achieve benefits that go beyond what is possible with conventional materials. Carbon nanotubes is 300 times stronger than steel. This material is often referred to as capable of building a space elevator. As strange as it is to imagine an elevator ride up to the International Space Station, it does indicate that as skyscrapers get taller, carbon nanotubes with bonds stronger than those diamonds have, will be the key to getting further and further into the sky. These cylindrical carbon molecules have unusual properties, which are valuable for nanotechnology, electronics, optics and other fields of materials science and technology. Owing to the material's exceptional strength and stiffness, nanotubes have been constructed with length to diameter ratio of up to 132,000,000:1, significantly larger than for any other material. They are of two types: single-walled and multi-walled. Most single-walled nanotubes, SWNTs, have a diameter of close to 1 nanometer, and can be many millions of times longer. The structure of a SWNT can be conceptualized by wrapping a 1-atom thick layer of graphite called graphene into a seamless cylinder. Multi-walled nanotubes, MWNTs, consist of multiple rolled layers, concentric tubes, of graphene. There are two models that can be used to describe the structures of multi-walled nanotubes. Metallic microlattice stands at number 2. In 2011, researchers in California announced the creation of one of the lightest materials in the world, comprised of 99.99% air, with a density of 0.9 mg per cubic centimeter. Potentially useful as a shock absorber for vehicles, its thickness is actually 1/1000th that of water. A metallic microlattice is composed of a network of interconnecting hollow struts. In the least dense microlattice sample reported, each strut is about 100 micrometers in diameter, with a wall 100 nanometers thick. Metallic microlattices may find potential applications as thermal and vibration insulators such as shock absorbers, and may also prove useful as battery electrodes and catalyst supports. Additionally, the microlattice's ability to return to their original state after being compressed may make them suitable for use in spring-like energy storage devices. Automotive and aeronautical manufacturers are using microlattice technology to develop extremely lightweight and efficient structures that combine multiple functions, such as structural reinforcement and heat transfer, into single components for high-performance vehicles. Graphene aerogel, a Chinese innovation, is being hailed as a revolutionary absorbent for use in oil spilled or other industrial situations. According to its developers, it is derived from a gel that has its liquid components replaced with gas. It appears solid, but weighs hardly anything and is extremely absorbent. It now owns several world records when it comes to insulation, density, and strength. My favorite potential use that observers mention for aerogel: building a space dome on the moon. A graphene aerogel that is 7 times lighter than air. A cubic centimeter of the graphene aerogel weighs just 0.16 milligrams, or, if you're having a problem conceptualizing that, a cubic meter weighs just 160 grams, 5.6 ounces. The graphene aerogel is so light that a cube inch of the stuff can be balanced on a blade of grass, the stamen of a flower, or the fluffy seed head of a dandelion. Most aerogels are produced using a sol-gel process, where a gel is dehydrated until only the aerogel remains. These were the top 5 lightest materials on Earth. Thank you for watching. For more videos, please subscribe.